Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Mark Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast. This is Vlookup Range. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. Today's question is sent in by Jer. Jer wants to do a Vlookup, and he wants to know if it can return a range. All right, so he has some cost centers here, and he says anything from 0001 to 0999 should be called fixed assets. Well, yeah, there is an obscure version of Vlookup that will do this. Let me turn this into a nice little table here. I'm going to use data text to columns, Alt DE, fixed width, and let's see, that looks pretty good right there. We'll keep that. I don't need this one. I actually don't need that one, but we'll leave it just to show how it works and click finish. So there's my table. And again, really all we need is the starting number and the description. We don't need the ending number. So we start out with equal VLOOKUP. We're looking up the 4750, comma. Here's our table range. I'll press F4 to lock that down, and we want the 1, 2, third column, comma, 3, comma. What do we put at the end of every single VLOOKUP? False, but not this VLOOKUP. When we're doing a range lookup, the approximate match is looking for something in a range of numbers. We can either put true or just leave it off, and Excel will do the kind of lookup that Jer is looking for. Now, these over here are ran between, so it's changing all the time. So, 1000 to 1999 should be current assets, 23 current liabilities, 0153 fixed assets right there. How do I get the leading zeros to show? That is in format cells, custom. I used 0000. Now, that's funny that they think that that is a postal code for Portugal. Okay, whatever. It's four zeros to get those leading zeros to show. So these are just numbers over here. They're not text, and we should be good to go. You can actually let's delete that extra column just to prove that we don't need it. Change this back to column two, so it doesn't need the ending range. It's just anything from one. If it's one or higher, you're going to get fixed assets until you get to 1,000. Then 1,000 or higher, you're going to get current assets. These, of course, have to be sorted ascending. This is the only time you have to sort your lookup table. Hey, I want to thank Jared for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. I'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.